hard on that. So, I just had that up there. So, you can start over. Persuasive speeches, yeah? Alright, well, before I do that, you're all going to get your informative speech feedback on Tuesday of next week. That's not the exciting news. But I want to give you some like global, like something that kind of you can all gather from. So we're going to do that. So make sure that we understand the purpose of your speech. So some of you just gave us a bunch of information. I wasn't sure what we're supposed to get from it. What's my takeaway? It's especially important with your persuasive speech because you're going to try to get us to think or believe or feel or change our attitudes or something like that. So make sure you understand your purpose. Talk to your audience. Some of you, and I wrote this on your evaluation, you can watch it on your video, you guys talk at your visual. And I understand why you do that, but make sure you're talking, like you can gesture to your video, which is the next point on here, but make sure you're talking to your audience. Don't talk to your visual, or to your notes, or whatever you got. And then emphasize your visual. Some of you, on the other thing, some of you had a visual, but it was kind of there. You didn't really kind of do anything. It didn't add to your speech because you didn't really do anything, it was just kind of there. Now you're not required a visual for the persuasive speech, and I would say it'll be about half and half. Some will have visuals, some won't. And I've heard perfectly good speeches, persuasive speeches with a visual, and perfectly good ones without a visual, and bad ones with visual, and not so good ones without a visual. So whether you use visual is not important, but if you do use one, do something with it. Use good sources. Some of you have read in your reference page, these aren't the best sources, so. Make sure you're using good sources. We can talk more about that on Tuesday, what good sources are. Try to organize your speech. Make sure your speech flows. If I said something like your speech was disorganized or something like that, sometimes the speech didn't have a flow to it. So make sure your speech is organized. Give yourself some credit. Some of you, some of you didn't give yourself enough, credit for what you know. This is kind of something that you know about. So make sure you tell us that why you've chosen this topic, or why you're an expert on it, or why you're choosing this particular persuasion, and why you're an expert. So give yourself some credit, and make sure you check out your speech video. Now, while out on that, those of you that gave your speech on the second day, which would have been last Tuesday, last Thursday, whatever the second day of speech was. So that little guy is recorded. That one has watched probably 1,000 speeches. And in that time, it's not in good form anymore. And one of the things it does is it will lock up in the middle of speeches, and it'll just like display the image that it's stuck on, and you just have to wait for the battery to die, and then it resets. So some of you on that day, the second day of speeches, do not have a video. So I'm sorry about that. If you didn't want a video, then you're good. But so if you do your informative speech critique, just do it without watching the video. Think about what you thought about your speech. So that's that. And by the way, your informative speech critiques are due on the Tuesday we get back. So there's a box on the online classroom for you to post that. Now I'll send an email about it. The directions are on the information page of the Blackboard, but I'll also email it out to you and remind you that it's due on Thursday, on that Tuesday we get back. We get back. I get back from football. If you will not be going anywhere. Unless you're going to Chicago, then you're going to Chicago. So any questions about that? Okay. So, Thursday number two. That's the information about the informative speech critique. Persuasive speech class in the library on November 8th, and no class on November 10th. Now, we have something very exciting, not the exciting thing, I'm building this up, not the exciting thing I'm referring to, we have something very exciting that happens on Tuesday next week. Or it could happen before, who knows, what happens on Tuesday? Yeah, so I feel like it's my responsibility to remind you guys all to vote. So I feel like I've tried to be very impartial, so I'll just tell you why. So this was my house in Oklahoma, is a duplex, and you can see somebody defaced my Bernie sign. Now, I ended up having a passive-aggressive political discussion in my yard because you can see it says "fuck Bernie," but somebody wrote "fuck yeah Bernie." So, and then I eventually took the sign down, got another one. That one got stolen. Then I decided no more Bernie signs. So I had a Bernie sign in my yard. Then, when I moved here, I had a Johnson sign in my yard, right? And I remember I was trying to promote you guys going to the Trump speech, right? And I went to the Hillary rally. So, I told you I voted that day, but I didn't tell you who I voted for. So, this is my little one-minute deal to make sure you guys go out and vote. Whoever you want to vote for, you should go do it. So, that's that. So, are you guys ready for the exciting news?
Yeah.
We have a special guest speaker on Tuesday. One of the things you guys said on your feedback was two things. You wanted in-class time to work on your speeches with your colleagues, and you wanted more example speeches. So I was going to give you my own persuasive speech, and it was not going to be about The Walking Dead, but we have something better. So this guy's going to come talk to us. Frank Cordero. You're wondering, who is Frank Cordero? I'm going to let him share who he is on Tuesday, but I'm going to show you what he does. And the way I know him, he was friends with my grandmother for years. I've known him forever. I knew him when he was Father Frank. He's no longer a priest. And he will tell you, so this is what Frank does. That's who we were watching before class. That's Frank.
It's a mess.
He does. So does anyone know who Frank Cordero is? He's kind of a big deal. He's a big deal in Des Moines area. He actually has a Wikipedia page, right? He's a peace activist, co-founder of Des Moines Iowa Catholic Worker Group. He was a Roman Catholic priest until 2003, 2005. He decided he wanted a relationship with a woman. I have a feeling the relationship with a woman happened and then he left the priesthood. I think it was in reverse order. He's been in prison for, let's see, 8 6-month terms. And that's federal jail. That's, you know, federal, not just like the
little
county jail. Yeah. So, and I'm going to show you how he ends up in jail. So this is what Frank does.
So, watch and support as Jess and Alan, Eddie. Someone take Eddie.
I got your thing, Eddie.
Here to reclaim it. We've done it 3 years before. We'll do it again. This is an occupation. Someday we'll be here with lots more guys.
I gotta give you credit for being persistent.
Thank you very much.
No, 15 minutes or 15 seconds. This is as far as you can go. And unfortunately, we don't choose to turn around and offer us.
Well, we're not going to turn around. We're not going to turn around. We won't turn around. All right.
You're all under arrest.
Oh, okay. Officer, well, then if you put us under arrest, we'll do what you tell us to do.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Cordero. Yes, sir. Well, he knows this guy. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank
yes.
you,
Mr.
Cordero. It is Dave.
Anybody who would like to join us, that's
stop
him with
thanks, guys.
And I'll just save you the suspense. He does his thing, you'll get arrested in the air.
They're like friends.
What point was that?
And usually what happens is, they just get like a trespassing charge and then they spend the night in jail and then the judge the next day is like, stop doing that and pay a fine. And they refuse to pay, they don't pay fines. Well, first of all, they don't have any money. They're just granolas that run around and protest. He spent the last 6 weeks at the Dakota Pipeline trying to block that, but that didn't work. His special friend, he's 65. This right here, right here is his special friend who is my age, so you could argue he's doing something right with his life. Or maybe he's doing something completely wrong, I don't know.
Special friend.
Okay, so, I don't really understand why they got arrested, or like what the situation was, like their backstory.
Yeah. Well, it's a...
Like, I just want them to
know. So, you know, actually, one of my students in the other class, that she works, has a friend who works for the World Food Prize. I think it's... Well, here, actually, hold on.
Well, you know,
you guys, I'm not really sure either, but you can ask him on...